Julie, congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Were you remotely expecting it or not? I mean, there was so much love in the room for you. It sounds a bit cheesy, but there really was.
Well, I honestly wasn't, because there were three of us up from Corrie. We thought we'd split the Corrie balls. And honestly, I know I'm going to sound like I'm saying this, but I didn't mind losing to Jessie at all, because I think she's wonderful.
She said the same about you,
though. Did she? Yeah. Oh, that's not... She even knows who I am. It's like, brilliant.
Oh, yeah. She said she'd been watching the Goodbye Hayley storyline. I mean, obviously, you've been there, what, 16 years?
Yeah.
I mean, was it a dream role for you?
Really? Oh, it really, really was. And it was beyond my wildest dreams, you know, to deal with the issues that we've dealt with it, and especially in this last year, all the stuff about pancreatic cancer and, you know, the way that we've moved things forward in terms of awareness for that, and this whole, like, debate that we've brought into people's homes about the right to die thing. I just feel really proud of it. It's like, to get a job like Corrie is amazing enough, but to have a job that has all this attached to us is something else, you know.
Have you seen many celebs hanging about? Because I think everyone's been touched by your storyline. What have people been saying to you?
Oh, people have just been saying really nice things. And it's like, it's amazing to me, because, you know, you exist in a bit of a bubble in Corrie, and I'm meeting lovely Jenna Louise Coleman, you know, who's Clara in Doctor Who. It's proper starstruck, and she watches it, so I'm like, that's made my night. I was a winner already before.
And so you've obviously left now. Have you got to keep the wig or not? The Hayley
wig? I've got the wig, I've got the anorak, I've got it all, yeah.
Nice.
Oh, I've got it all stashed away, yeah.
And when you were kind of clearing up after being there for 16 years, did you find anything in your dressing room that you were like, oh,
I found all sorts. I found all sorts of things. I mean, it was 16 years full of stuff. You know what us women are like, especially.
Gorgeous,
it's like,
yeah.
And Ali King, who plays Carla, whose dress this is, hilarious. Like, she's looking after me still off screen as
nice.
Well. She was in the dressing room with me. And every time I tried to throw something away, she was like, give it me. I'll have it. Even pictures of my kids, you know, I have copies of them at home. She was like, give it to me, give it to me.
I bet it's been very difficult to leave, hasn't it?
It was really difficult. It was a real wrench to go. But you know what? I felt like the time was right. And I thought, if I don't do it now, I never will.
And
so this is the greatest present.
It's brilliant,
so
isn't it?
Oh,
Michelle leaving at the same time so you can go and be the next Scott and Bailey?
Oh, no. I hadn't thought of that, but yes, that's right. Well, I think Scott and Bailey are doing pretty well as it is, you know.
Oh, yeah,
I don't think they're ready to retire
you
yet.
You can rival them, though. Have you got any plans? Seriously, you're going to...
Well, I'm doing theatre at the moment. I'm opening in a play in Manchester tomorrow night, so I've got to be really listening to my voice already. I'm going to be
You've
able to.
Got to let your hair down, though. Do
well,
you know?
I don't think I'm going to. I'm going to have to be really sensible because I'm so nervous. And then I'm doing another play, and then after that, who knows? So I don't know. I mean, you know, it might be a while before you see me on telly again, but hopefully
not.
You will.
I hope we do. Listen, congratulations.
Thank you so. This is like off the scale list. Thank you. Thank
very
you.
Well deserved.
Thank you. Thanks so much.